you guys. I think I'm live. Okay, so I wanted to just jump on here for a quick minute. I usually do my lives on Tuesdays at 5, but sometimes when I'm feeling just motivated and led to talk to you guys, I'll jump on here. There's a lot of folks here who are new, and you're new to me and you're new to the page. And so anyway, this is how I do things. But I wanted to just speak to you guys about something that I'm seeing so much of right now. And I want to just point this out, point something out to you to try to help you with this. So a lot of you are married, and or maybe you're in a really long-term relationship. And the thing is, so many of you are actually headed toward divorce. You don't realize that you're headed toward divorce, but you really are, because you don't have the tools to fix this relationship that you're in, and you're just going down that road. And it's just a matter of how far along you are in the process toward eventually getting a divorce. And I had a client yesterday, I was talking to her about that, and she said, gosh, that is such a scary thing to hear. And it really is. That's not what you want for your relationship. But I want to share with you something that I'm seeing a lot of you do when you first come to me, when you come into the group, when you start my communication program, or you start coaching with Debbie, our spectrum relationships, Asperger's coach, or when you do private coaching with me. You are very much in a place of antagonism in your relationship. And what that means is that you, and I talk about this in my lives, you guys, but what that means is that you really are in opposition with your partner. And I'm speaking to both of you, neurotypicals and those of you who are autistic. And so you're in opposition. It's like you're fighting. You're against each other. It's me or you. And so that means somebody has to win when you get into these disagreements, and somebody has to lose. And as long as you have this antagonistic dynamic and you don't figure out how to be on the same team, you will continue moving more and more toward an eventual end of the relationship, whether that's ending this long-term relationship that you're in or divorcing. So what's really, really critical, and I put in the title of this, is what you can do to prevent this, is take off the boxing gloves, like you're in a boxing ring, and develop an attitude of curiosity. Curiosity is so critical. And what I mean here is it's important to be curious, to try to be curious about what's happening. Be curious about your partner. Be curious about yourself, because both of you are bringing, this is stage one of communication in the communication transformation program, both of you are bringing so much to this relationship. Some of it's really awesome, but some of these dynamics that are causing the conflict, where you cycle over and over in conversations that are just argumentative, so much of that, you each are bringing your own values, your goals for these conversations, your perspectives, your previous hurts and wounds, whether it's from childhood or previous relationships even, or your own relationship, the narratives that you've already gotten, that you've created about this relationship, that, by the way, some of those are not accurate, which we learn in the communication program. So you have to be curious about it, instead of just, so many of you, most of you, when you come in, you're focused on what you need, how you need your partner to be different, how you need your partner to change, what you need from them, what you need them to do differently, what you need him to say, what you need him to do, what you need her to do or say. And once we've gotten into this place of what I need from my partner, what's got to happen, we're starting to be controlling. without realizing it. And a lot of people don't like to acknowledge this, but we're starting to control things, and we're starting to try to control our partner and to try to control the relationship to get what we want. This is normal. This is a normal part of the, it's normal, but it's not function, not functional. It's dysfunctional, but it's a normal part of a relationship that is going down. I want you to hear me. You, if you are in this, if this is, if this sounds familiar to you, you are in a relationship that is going down. So you've got to be curious and be a detective. I'm always telling you guys, be a detective to try to unpackage what's actually happening. What is the why? What is the why behind your actions, your feelings, your partner's behaviors and actions? It's not what you think. If you are in an autism spectrum relationship and you're just now discovering it after you've been in this relationship for a while, or maybe you've known it for a while, the why that's beneath behaviors and actions is not what you think for either one of you, whether you're neurotypical or you're autistic. It's not what you think. You have to let go of what you think you know. And you have to learn. That's why I have this free coaching group here for you guys, to help you learn, to help you, to teach you the things that you don't know. So much here. There's so much here. You absorb it, soak it up, get on my lives, watch the replays. And then I have the Spectrum Straight Talk Library, with it's got so many videos in there, over 50, but there's going to be several hundred once we finish this big edit, this update that I'm doing to it. Get in the communication transformation program. The next enrollment for the coaching group will be for a couple more months, but you can start the self-study. This start learning these tools to communicate with each other. Educate yourselves. Be curious. But you've got to step out away from this antagonism where you see each other as the enemy, where you see your partner as the enemy, where you see your partner as being the reason for your unhappiness, for the reason for your failing marriage. Got to stop doing that and start being a detective, because as long as you stay stuck in the if he would only or if she would only, your marriage is going down, you guys. And I don't want that to happen for you. All right. I hope you guys are listening and that you have a good afternoon or evening, wherever it is you are. Drop me your comments in the feed here. Let me know what you think.